Welcome back, everybody. My name is Ben Schubert. I'm a filmmaker, and today I want to talk about processing. Today I want to talk about processing Canon RAW footage. Generally, I shoot RAW on my C200, but what we're going to be talking about today will apply to RAW whether you're shooting on a C300, C500, or whatever else. There shouldn't be much difference there. If there is, this should get you essentially going in the right direction. So usually when I'm processing this raw footage, I'm doing it for three reasons. Either one, I'm transcoding it out for another editor or someone else to take over, and I'm usually transcoding that into ProRes so they can take it, work on it easily. The other thing I do is I transcode it for myself for ProRes, but I take a slightly different approach in that I do a bit of corrections and a bit of adjustments before I actually export it, and then that makes my life easier for when I'm doing post. But that being said, I won't do that for someone else because I think it would just mess with their system, whereas it works for my system. And then the third way is I will just edit this raw in DaVinci Resolve and then grade it at the end, which seems to work pretty well for me. Now, all three of these uses basically use the same process. I just stop at different parts of them. So the general process is fairly simple. Copy my media to my drives, import it into DaVinci Resolve. This is where I do most of my preliminary work. I don't use any other system for this. For me, Premiere just doesn't really work with my Canon RAW footage. That might just be my system, which is fine. So DaVinci Resolve is always where I start. So I start off by importing my footage, bringing it in, and there's different schools of thoughts of whether you should copy your media to your drives or just transcode straight from the cards. I'll leave that to you. I do transcode from the cards sometimes. I don't think it's the best practice, but it's still one I do. So I'll leave it in your hands. So from there, I'll bring all my media into my timeline. And so if I'm just editing it myself, you know, maybe I'll have an editing process that I'm following and, you know, I'll go through that and then we'll get to color correction later. But if I'm sending this to someone else, I will bring it into my timeline and then I'll go straight to coloring. So once I take it into the coloring portion, this is where the process kind of really starts. So first thing I do is I start with one clip, probably the first clip, or maybe it's the, you know, most average clip for what I'm working with. And the first thing that I want is I want to get access to all the Canon information so that I can have more control over things. So you want to start off by essentially changing some settings, so it'll say something like full clip. So you want to get those clip settings, and then you want to get the Canon specific settings. And then once you have access to that, then you get all the real raw metadata that you're looking for. And to start off, I want to start with getting the Canon Cinema Gamut color space, because this will give me the most color space to work with in post if I'm going to ProRes. And so if I'm getting it to someone else, I want to make sure that they have the most, you know, to work with. And so that after that, I choose my color space, which I usually go with Canon C-Log2. Now, Canon C-Log2 gives you the most dynamic range to work with in post. 1 and 3 will, you know, crush things down a little, make it more contrasty, which is fine. There's definitely arguments for using those at certain times. And if you'd planned for that, then go for it. Right? If that makes sense for matching your cameras in post, then that's what you should use. But for me, I typically go with Canon C-Log2 just because it gives me the most range for after my edit. So from here, you can go through the settings and make sure it looks, you know, essentially the way you want it. I would keep a light hand here. You don't want to do too much because you want to make sure that everything is in a good position for post to really work with. At this point, you just want to get things as neutral as possible. And so if I'm transcoding this for someone else, this is where I will essentially copy this across all my footage and then send it away. I don't want to add contrast. I don't want to add a curve. I don't want to do anything. I want them to have the most neutral version as possible in ProRes at whatever quality of ProRes makes sense for them. So I'll send that off. If you wanted to make graded proxies for them, you could do that and then send those off as well. And then they could match them up, leave that in their hands. I don't know. So if I'm sending this to someone else, I want to keep it as neutral as possible and I'll send it off here. So I'll stop here, export it, send it to them and whatever, however they want it. But for me, if I'm taking this into Premiere, I want a bit more color information. I want a bit more things to work with because frankly, I do not love color grading in Premiere. I think that it's lacking a lot of things, and especially, you know, against DaVinci Resolve, which is pretty great, it can be a little lackluster. So for me, I'll do all those things, but I will go to the color channels and I will turn up the red channel, the blue channel, and the green channel and go from here. So for me, this will give me way more saturation to work with in Premiere. You can always dial it down, but getting it back up can be annoying to do in Premiere. So this is just where I like to start. I won't normally do any like major grading before sending it to Premiere, but just adding that color really helps. And so otherwise, if I've been editing in DaVinci Resolve and I'm now color grading, that's a different story. This is where I will get my baseline to, send it to all my clips, and then I will actually start properly grading everything. So this is what I do. And I might do this first, actually, before I even edit and add a contrast curve and then do my editing and then come back and do a proper grade after. So I hope this helps. I hope there was some good information here. Give it a thumbs up if you found this helpful. Otherwise, if you want to see more filmmaking, camera-related content, you can subscribe and follow along. And yeah, otherwise, I'll see you later.